Blackstone presents New Rules for Reprobates by Michael Anderle. This book is read by Sarah Mollo-Christensen. Chapter 1. Dealing with the bugs had taken some getting used to. The scourge had its own challenges, but they weren't too unsettling, in her opinion. Wrecking the bots felt odd, but not enough to stick in her brain. The mutants were something else, though. Chill had no idea what might have caused them, where they had come from, or why they were acting the way they were. She didn't know much about how biological agents acted. While she'd heard that most of modern human history had been guided by planets of origin being decimated by biological agents, no one had much fear of using the damn things. Hell, as the stories went, humans had been driven off their planet of origin by biological agents. That hadn't changed anyone's mind about them. The Daheen hadn't had that problem, so they wouldn't have learned the same lessons. They had a lot more excuses than humans did. "I'm telling you," Chill muttered, drawing her knife. "One day, we will find ourselves easy-ass work helping people with no adverse moral implications and a hell of a lot of creds paid into our account. A cushy job where we don't end up fighting monsters." Cortez tilted his head and watched her.
"What in our time together gives you the slightest inkling we'll be doing anything like that in the near future?"
She shrugged. "It's simple physics. Every action has an equal and opposite reaction, which means that since we've been putting ourselves up against the worst and the ugliest the galaxy has to offer, we're bound to come upon some good luck in the future to balance our bad luck."
"I don't think that's how physics works,"
Ivan noted. He checked his knives one last time.
"For one thing, there's no such thing as luck when it comes to physics. Equal and opposite reaction does not apply in this situation."
Chill grinned. "Well, I don't care. There's an element of spirituality in my understanding of the universe and physics, so to my mind, all the bad shit that's happened to us lately means we're going to have good shit happening to us soon."
"But if good and bad are a matter of perspective,"
Cortez chimed in,
"you'll have to put time and effort into making sure that whatever the universe sends you is good for you, not just for the majority of the universe."
"You're overthinking this." She shook her head as she ran a whetstone across her knife's blade. Her suit's HUD was useful for ensuring the edge was straight and as sharp as she could make it.
"You're underthinking this,"
Ivan shot back.
"Waiting for the universe to give you good shit will let bad shit keep happening to you. You have to be the change you want to see in the universe."
"That's bullshit, and you know it. I'm not waiting for good shit to happen anyway. We're all working our collective asses off, knowing all our hard work is eventually going to pay dividends and allow us to have our pick of what we want to do later on. Hopefully, we'll all still be alive and more or less intact by that time, but that's what we have coming to us."
"So you're saying that once we've paid our dues in the merc business and made ourselves as popular as we can through the vid thing, we can get paid for working decent jobs that don't have us dealing with monsters galore?"
"Something like that. See? Equal and opposite reaction." Talking to them was better than keeping it all in her head. She was brooding too much, and it was good to get those thoughts out of her head. Share them, so the rest of the crew could brood with her. She'd watched a bunch of vids, promotional material from security companies who were always looking for new and exciting talent to add to their rosters. She'd been contacted by the recruiters for those companies. Generic, cold messages saying they'd spotted the crew and liked their resume. Would they come in for an interview at their earliest convenience? Those security companies hired their mercs to cores looking to start wars without inciting them. That, or had them babysitting a bunch of rich fucks who wanted to have muscle on their side when they started their wars. Chill didn't want any part of that, especially since they would be the newest crew. They would get the worst assignments until they'd proven themselves. It also meant they would need to work for terrible people without questioning them. Chill wouldn't commit to that. Maybe after word got out to the proper folks about what they were doing on the Serpent and what their skill set was, they would get better offers. Not easy work, just the sort that wouldn't...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.